The next topic of friction is angle of friction. The angle made by the resultant vector R of normal reaction L and the static frictional force Fs with normal to the surface is called angle of friction. Here there are three physical quantities. This is resultant, this is normal reaction and Fs. Okay, let us consider a surface or a ground, a surface, this is surface, a horizontal surface. Let us consider a horizontal surface here and place a body on this surface. Body of mass M, mg, which is W, the weight of the body acting on the horizontal surface. This is center of mass. This dot is center of mass. This is N, normal reaction. Normal reaction developed by surface acts on the center of mass of the body. Then if this body is sliding or we applied some force in this direction to slide this body, even the body is not sliding, then the frictional force Fs acts in this direction. Suppose this is east. If I want to slide this body towards the east direction, the frictional force acts towards the west direction. Then this is a vector. This is one vector, normal reaction vector due to surface. This is frictional force, which is opposing force. These two are vectors. Then this is R, this is resultant vector. Already I marked here, this is R, this is the resultant of this vector. Then this is Fs, this will be Fs, this is N, this also vector, this also N, this is parallel to this, this dotted lines. Okay, then if an angle is making with resultant, this theta, normal reaction is making an angle theta here, then this also theta, this also theta. We have to find the values of N and Fs. We have to find N and Fs. If we consider, of course this is origin, O, which is origin. If we want to find N and Fs, here the frictional force F is equal to mu into N. This is the formula of friction. Here I consider this is static friction because this body is not moving in any direction. So this is Fs, this is mu s into N. This is equation number 1. Find Fs, the static frictional force. For that, consider this triangle here. Here, the opposite side, this is theta, the opposite side represents Fs, and hypotenuse represents R. So we have to take sine theta here, the opposite side of the theta is Fs by this is hypotenuse, this is opposite to the 90 degrees, this is hypotenuse, this is called FS, this is called R. Then FS is equal to R sine theta. This is equation number 2. Equation number 2. And find cos theta. You have to consider this triangle, this part. That is cos theta. You have to find this is opposite side is the dotted line. No use here. So cos theta is equal to this 90 degrees. This will be hypotenuse. This will be adjacent side. Adjacent is n by hypotenuse is r. Then n is equal to r cos theta. This is equation number 3. Equation number 3. This is from 1. From equation 1, we know Fs is equal to mu s into n. Fs is equal to mu s into n. So mu s is equal to Fs by n. That is equal to put equation 2 and 3 in this equation. Then mu s is equal to the coefficient of friction. Mu s is equal to r sin theta. R sin theta by r cos theta. R gets cancelled. This is equal to tan theta. So it will be tan theta. Then mu s is equal to tan theta. The angle of friction is equals to its tangent. That means that it is the resultant vector will be intermediate of this normal reaction and this static friction, and the resultant is equals to its coefficient of friction. Okay, this is angle of friction expression. Okay, angle of repose. Suppose a body is rest on the plane, whether that may be horizontal plane or inclined plane. Here we are assuming an inclined surface here by making an angle theta with the horizontal surface. I kept a body of mass on this inclined surface, inclined plane. Then the weight of the body W is equal to mg acts towards the ground, and the normal reaction of this surface acts perpendicularly to the inclined surface. This is n. Then this, if I extend this vector like this, if this is making an angle theta, this is theta, this is theta, this theta, then this weight mg resolves into two perpendicular components. If I draw one more vector perpendicular to this vector, which is normal to the inclined surface, then this will be, this vector is called mg cos theta, and this is mg sin theta. So mg cos theta and mg sin theta. If this body is static on this surface, static on this inclined plane, Fs is equal to mg sin alpha. That means it tends to move in the downward direction. Then friction starts. to stop this
body.
This is generally, this alpha is called it as a critical angle, I think. Then this alpha is alpha. This is equation number 3 and this is equation number 4. According to friction, loss of friction, loss of friction, Fs is equal to mu s into n. Fs is equal to mu s into n. Then mu s is equal to Fs by n. This is equation number 5. This is equation number 5. Put equation 3 and 4 in equation 5. Put equation 3 and 4 in equation 5. We get mu s is equal to fs means mg sin alpha, mg sin alpha by mg cos alpha. Mg gets cancelled. Mu s is equal to tan alpha. Means the numeric value of tan alpha is equals to the numeric value of the coefficient of friction here. So that is angle of repose. That means if I put this angle to critical angle, still that body was in stationary condition due to because of the friction developed in the opposite direction. Still that is called static friction. Still the body is not moving. Then another thing is the angle of friction also, in previous topic, the angle of also mu s is equal to some tangent of theta. That means in a horizontal plane, the angle of friction, and on inclined plane the angle of repose are numerically equals to the coefficient of friction here. So this is the topic, important topic in the friction. So prepare well. Okay, thank you. If this body is static on this inclined plane, then here we have to write this frictional force acting normal to the surface, which is in the opposite direction here. So let us write the values of these quantities. If I increase this inclination theta up to alpha, because alpha is greater than theta. This is a numeric value. For suppose this is if this represents the 45 degrees, maybe alpha represents more than 45 degrees, some numeric value. Then what happens? This body slides in the downward direction. Then it develops some friction here. Okay? Then this becomes N is equal to mg cos alpha, and F is equal to mg